Welcome back, everybody, into your coverage of the SinaCup Season 3. I am your host for the English live stream, TobiWan, bringing you now your winner's bracket final, game at number 2, where DK is going up against Vici Gaming. DK having a very convincing game number 1, with the roaming bounty hunter working absolutely flawlessly, nerfing out their enchantress, and eventually a very, very fat lifestealer came through and just went munch, munch, nom, nom, all over the Vici Gaming's asses. Let's get ourselves, though, into game number 2 and hope for something a little bit different, a little bit closer, and the man joining me for today's broadcast is, of course, our expert in Dota. It is MiSeRy, man. Welcome back for game number 2. What do you hope to see coming out of this draft right now?
Oh, I would like to see maybe VG like thinking a bit more about what they're doing in the draft. I don't want to see a game like the first one. I'd like to see a 50-minute Chinese mind game, 5-man Dota kind of game. That would be cool. DK first picking Venomancer right now.
Hell, he got banned out in the last draft in the first two, so
yeah.
I love him, man. I love him. This Veno is kind of like the new kid on the block as far as the multi-purpose guy, because he always just used to be that lane control, and people are like, oh, Venomancer Gale is really like crap now. Especially
yes.
Level 1, which, like, I do no damage, it's like, ugh. But he's able to just morph himself into a laner if something goes wrong.
Mm. He's like, really hard to play against.
He's the ultimate plan C.
He's like, you know, Chinese play him mid lane, they play him off lane, they play him ice style, off lane with boots and stuff. He's also the support as we know him. But he's really hard to play against because of these wards. There is this time where he hits level 7 and then he sits mid lane and just spams wards. And there are times where you just can't do anything about him. You can try and smoke up and gang him, but then he gets his ultimate off and TP support, and then you end up dying for a Venomancer. It's not easy to play against that guy.
Well, Vici Gaming now going to go into the Batrider. Rather dangerous to do when Nyx Assassin is still on the field, because he can get controlled out very easily, and while DK's saying no to that, even with a Shadow Shaman and a Batrider on the field, they ban out the Lycan, but they grab up the Wisp, so welcome to combo heroes.
That's so intimidating, that Wisp pick. For VG, I think.
Because they know right now they're going to have to waste one of their bans. I say waste, it's not really a waste, because you know what DK are trying to do, but they're going to take out the Tiny. There is no other option for him right now. They know the steamrolling power that can come out from that Tiny.
Yeah, I kind of have to agree with you. I feel like that combo is just too strong for not to banning it out.
Mm. But then the question is then asked, what combo do we look for from DK?
It's just so hard to ban. I think banning Tiny is okay, but apart from that, I feel like it's hard to ban against like a Wisp pick like that, because there's still so many directions you can go with that duo. It's been figured out that you can play him even without having this super combo kind of hero like CK or Tiny. You can just play him as a normal hero as well.
I do still find it hilarious just how much CK Tiny has dropped off.
CK Wisp, yeah.
CK Wisp, sorry. Yeah. It's just completely dropped off.
Yeah, it has. I guess it comes down to that stun.
Mm.
Now that it's slow. The reality rift.
Yeah. Whisper's used more as a buff than a ganker anymore. So, yeah, your CNG with a CK kind of... Yeah. That really is actually exactly the reason why it's fallen off.
Mm-hmm.
But ROTK, man, he's taken every bit of his extra time to work out this ban. And he's actually going to go with the Elder Titan. Now, this is slightly surprising, but not, because this is also another draft, which I think he's... I think this is the reason why RTK is banning it out, because it was Wisp and Sniper were being combined together with an ET.
All right.
So they ran the ET off lane. It was a Venomancer supportier on the bottom lane with the Wisp, and they were just doing pulling and stuff like that. And every now and then, Venom would rotate in the middle lane. But basically, it made it almost impossible to fight up against him.
I think that's a good ban, actually. I actually think there's also the chance that DK will go into a Panda Wisp combination as well. So it is hard to ban, and he's not going to choose to ban Tiny.
Takes out the Prophet instead. Make sure there's not full global control. And then DK would pick something like Well, I wasn't thinking Doombringer. I was thinking Spectre. Got the full global. Unfortunately for Spectre, Wisp isn't really going to give him that much.
I guess they could go for Spectre, but I don't think they have to this game.
Yeah, no, they don't, man. This is a tiny game for them. They've just been given it. It's like Vici Gaming, though, asking them to pick up Tiny, which means they've got to have enough control. It's the nice thing I like about Vici Gaming's lineup. Their level of control is very, very high. From the Doom to Shackles as well as Hexes, the Batrider Blinken to Lasso, they've got a good blend of initiation, stability, as well as pushing power. And so far, DK have a Venno as well as a Wisp. So they have a great Ling controlling hero, and they have a buff up hero. The other three cores, you have to do so much work here for DK.
It's true enough, but the thing about VG's heroes as of now is that they are kind of slow at coming into the game. Whereas Wisp and Venomancer are basically really strong from minute one. Resta, Doom, and Bat, they all need levels, they all need kind of their like, what's it called? Their core items, you know, to be useful. But I think Nyx is a good pick again. It's good against Bat, and it also will get to six kind of fast because of, like I just mentioned, Doom, Resta, and Bat, right? And they can't really run a Nyx over here.
Actually, one hero we haven't mentioned, again, managed to bypass our entire first game. But is this a Brewmaster game? Like, I know we're going up against a Doombringer. But is this going to be a Wisp Brewmaster game?
I actually don't think so. I feel like 10 seconds remaining. VG has two good heroes against Brewmaster. Brewmaster is also kind of good against those, but then they would have to put Mushi on carry, most likely. And I don't think that's... I'm not sure if DK is the team that actually plays Brewmaster of all the Chinese.
So far, I haven't seen them do it yet.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Let's just see him get the Tiny. It's kind of got to be.
There's so many ways they can go about this. Yeah,
there it is. At the end of the day, it's just too appetizing to have the ability with a Wisp and Tiny. No matter what point of the game you go to, like you asked at the start of this draft to have like a 50-minute classic old Chinese game. With a Wisp and Tiny, at 50 minutes, DK have the advantage. Because DK are the ones that can just relocate in, and even with backdoor regeneration up, they can still take out tier 3 towers, and possibly even bring down Raxus.
It's just too solid not to go for that Tiny.
Yeah.
But I mean, VG must have kind of expected that Tiny to come out.
Oh, they had to know it.
Yeah.
But they also chose the fact they wouldn't ban against it. Like the heroes they removed out, like the Nature's Prophet as well as the ET, it was for different strides, it was for different problems. So they must believe that they can kill off that Tiny. Reserve
time. I think what they should do, and what they probably are doing too, is focus on their own kind of lineup more and try and figure out how they want to go about that. And I feel like their supports now are really strong. And if they actually do get off with a good early game, they're going to be really strong in the mid game before Tiny starts getting items.
Mm-hmm. Well, last ban out by Mushi. It's actually rather difficult to ban out against the VG Gaming lineup. He's just going to remove the DK. Nice tanky hero will give him another element of push and would be the mid solo that they could be worried about. And I'm actually interested to see, too, what DK is going to be running, because obviously we've talked about Ice being that Nyx Assassin on the offlane, but we also talked about him being the Venomancer on the offlane. So how do we now actually start to lame this for DK?
It's not going to be a Venomancer offlane. It's probably going to be Nyx offlane and the standard supports bottom with the Tiny. And then some... DK maybe a Puck again bit or something like that. I can see that. A Morphling. That's interesting.
Yeah, this is one of these heroes now where you got to kind of look for a little bit more lockdown silence coming out from DK. But that Morphling selection, this is an answer to the possibility of the split. We're having that Replicant, you can jump so freely around the map. Yes, you want to know what I hope? You can't, not with the Doombringer on the field. No, I take back my thought of, I'm not going to share it, so I don't technically have to take it back. Well, we're getting Undying.
I don't think that was your thought.
No, that wasn't my thought, but...
It's offline Undying. Maybe even...
No, it's not. This is aggro tri-lane Undying.
Yeah, it is.
This is Undying, Tiny, as well as Wisp heading north. We got Nyx Assassin going to be heading towards the mid, and Venomancer will solo the off lane.
That's really cool.
Solo the safe lane, sorry.
That's really cool. I think that's a really cool idea by DK, because Venomancer is going to be really heavy on bottom lane, and Nyx Fast 6 on mid lane.
And this kind of stops Vici Gaming too, if Vici Gaming were considering a tri lane themselves, this kind of screws them up as well.
This also leaves VG with a serious like issue here. Like, what do they do now? You know, do they still just go safe lane and fight this lane? Or do they try and dodge, put Morphling, Rubick bottom, or some kind of duel where they try and dodge? Or what do they do? It's not an easy decision.
Well, we'll see what they decide right now, so...
I think they're just going to go safe.
Well, RTK was heading up north for the moment. And Vici Gaming, okay, they're having a lot of indecision right now. As far as DK goes, we're actually running the burning MMY lane, the Wisp Tiny lane, down the bottom lane. Ice has picked up a Wraith Band, is going a mid build on the Venomancer, which shifts the off lane to be Mushy with Stout Shield, 8 Tango charges. And Lanham's up here to start with, but it's just for wards. So they'll actually run a defensive tri lane with the Nyx off lane, but it's in the hands of Mushy. So they've switched up their roles, but the heroes are actually very normal to a point, apart from like the Venom in mid. Not as normal.
It's actually also a pretty cool idea. The only thing is that I'm not sure this Undying Nyx lane, they both have Stout Shields. It could work out for them, but if they actually die, if they make mistakes, it could be really fatal for them. The Venomancer mid is going to be happy against the Doom for sure.
Look at him switching. See, this is the point when I'm going to say Nyx can go one-on-one with Super. Put Undying back on the bottom lane. Lanham's just here to wait it out, so then he can put down a nice aggressive Observer Ward or something like that. His only downside is he'll be dewarded almost instantly. Because there's already the Observer Ward of Vici Gaming. And they watch both the runes so closely. It'll be a regeneration for MMY.
Look at these lanes. This is really smart by Vici. This is probably the most efficient way they could do it. Put Doom up against that lane top and have them morph mid. Because they know that the strongest lane is not going to be mid. It's either going to be this Nyx or probably Nyx is what they expect. But even against the Venom, he's also going to be okay.
They're switching the lanes again. FY as well as Fenrir showed themselves battling over the bottom rune. So they're switching both of them up towards the top lane. So it's a very good thing that actually Lanham didn't head down to bottom lane. He is going to stay up here on the top.
Well, I actually thought that they could have done a tri-lane offensive against this Batrider. I mean, against this Wisp Tiny, and that would have been...
Speaking of Batrider, he seems to be rather low on life right there. It's kind of like, oh, I'm not going to miss first blood in this game, and then all of a sudden Batrider sitting at one third of his life points. Just through a little bit of Wisp and Tiny harassment. Because Tiny's already used Avalanche over an RTK. And he's already had to trigger off his first consumable. That's going to be problematic.
But with this lane setup, I feel like still DK is getting more out of it.
It does kind of feel that way. Like, even this middle lane, like Ice, it's going to really get a burst in levels. And I like the way he's building into this as well. We haven't seen him level up his second ability just yet. Instead, though, he's just holding out, seeing if he needs the Gale, if he needs Plague War, so he hits level 3, then he can go the 1-1-1 across the board. But his harassment level on Siler is great. I actually almost want to see Ice do a Trixie thing and go the double Gale. This was something Trixie did, because once you hit the 4 points up in Gale, you're actually able to zone any hero out of the lane as a Venomancer. You just need basic clarity regen.
Yeah, but then again, if he just goes for the max ward build, he can just like make an army of wards on the Morphling's hill, and he can't do anything about it.
Yeah.
I feel that's the more safe way of doing it. But right
he's,
now, I mean,
he's
Nyx
gone,
again.
He's gone aggressive. He's done the double Gale.
Oh, he is.
I'm down with this ice.
It's also annoying. I mean, regardless of what he does, I think Morphling is getting fucked.
Well, actually, this is the problem right now for Morphling. Like, what's he want to do? Is he going to want to just strength morph this? And he get 1 point up in the Plague Ward too? So he's got the Poison Sting ticking him down. He's got the Gale ticking him down. And there is nothing he can do but back up and wait for the bottle. But when he uses the bottle, he's going to expend the entire thing and then send it back to base before he can start fighting on the lane again. And then he just gets Galed up again. And he doesn't control the wards because the plague wards. Oh, you're right. There's the shackles. The Undying Tombstone, Spine Carapace. It's a return stun over on two. Mushy tries to get out, but there's still the shock coming out from Fenrir to get the kill. But Lanham, it's very much overextended up here. And he needs to get himself a really good decay so he can at least get a little bit more life points and maybe run out of here with the stick charges as well. He's going to go down. Mushy comes in looking for the last hit in FY, but will not be able to achieve it. So two heroes kills going the way of Vici Gaming on this offlane. On their safe lane, sorry.
That was really good for the VG, that's what it needed, definitely. Now I feel like they need to go and help that Morphling out a bit.
Yeah.
It can rotate one guy in there with full HP, full mana, and they can kill the Morph, I mean the Venomancer.
Yeah.
That would be big.
Those supports need to start moving over. That's 100% right. Smoke up and go. Does she have a smoke? Fenrir has got one. But he's also got no life points and mana, so...
I think he's going to go heal and then TP mid, or smoke mid, and have the TP ready. Because
yeah.
The rest and morph can probably kill the Venomancer. Yeah, he uses in this as well.
Ice is doing a combination of our two strats. Doesn't make it as powerful, especially when Sala can do this kind of stuff, but actually then again, Sala's going to be really careful. More Plague Wars, just focusing him down.
Yeah, look at this Resta moving now. He's going to maybe kill this Venomancer.
Depending on what Veno gets, the rune's on bottom, it's a haste rune. Sala wins the rune battle here.
Oh, yeah.
And Ice have to send this courier back. Oh, did MMY? Oh, no, Morphling did grab the haste rune. But there's no way he can keep up with the Wisp Tether. But they're going to have a crack at bottom lane. ROTK, Avalanche, able to connect, toss up into the air. The Wisp Spirit Balls are, oh, not enough damage. ROTK drops to 110 of his life points. And Fenrir got caught out coming middle lane.
Yeah, the momentum was a bit off there.
Yeah.
With the haste that was found, Venomancer was going to play careful, and yeah, it was just a bit off overall.
See, Ice is next item, and whoops, there goes your Batrider on bottom lane. Thought ROTK would have been a little bit more defensive after that last attack, but...
Oh, the Wisp was tossed in, so that was hard to...
Wait, to be defensive and not being able to defend yourself. Top lane, Mushy, trouble for him. He's going to get this Spike Carapace up, but they hex him up. There's your Spike Carapace. Tries to turn for the stun to give Lanham something to fight with as a centaur. In fact, coming out from the jungle, stunning up over on Super Fenrir's in a lot of trouble. Lanham's able to just pick him off. So it ends up being a one-for-one trade, not the best trade in the world. And they're TPing more support up towards the top lane, so Mushy returns to the lane. I think he really wants to come in and fight this straight away, but with Lanham also rotating over, looking for that decay on Super, dropping his life points down. We still got 815 plus those stick charges. There's no way they can really get a kill up here. While mid lane, I also wanted to keep my eyes a little bit closer on too, because Venomancer, I don't know if you saw him, but about 30 seconds ago, he was sitting at maybe 20 life points after the Morphling waved on him. It's such a troublesome lane for all lanes. There's killing potential from both sides.
Yeah, it's really cool laning phase, actually. Batrider did a really good job. You see, Tiny doesn't have the best farm. He doesn't have free farm, at least. And Batrider has 1,000 gold on top of boots. And he's level 6, so he did a good job. So the laning phase actually went better than I expected for VG. I guess that came down to the double kill top lane.
Mushy. Doom's gone off. The Undying dropping down the Tombstone. Mushy will be able to survive through this, or at least be denied. So when you're staying a little bit closer towards the top, I don't think that Doom shouldn't take him out.
Nah.
It's only that level 1 Doom, so he'll be fine. Yeah. But this Venomancer against the Morphling in mid, he's got a lot of experience mana levels. 3 points now up in the Plague Wars as well. Still gonna be careful with these Plague Wards, because he does start to feed a little bit over with those Plague Wards. Because they are worth some decent money now. It's kind of like Enigma Convergence worth more. Lanham. Basic stun out from Mushy, just trying to keep Fenrir away from him, and then a 3-man decay. Undying wants to start fighting this one. This guy's got almost 1k life points. Lanham knows he has the advantage. While on bottom lane, they're diving for ROTK. In through the tree line, Spirits, but ROTK just able to walk across the wall. And then it goes in for the Flame Break. MMY, he's low on life, and so is Burning, but the toss comes back in again, and MMY will burn the Firefly. They'll still be able to get the kill nonetheless. And there is no extra experience that gets to come the way of the Batrider because of it, but commitment and the Wisp is sacrificed for the kill on the Batrider. Lanham, trouble. Shackles. There's a follow-up hex. Mushy's trying to come in to give him some kind of space, but he didn't know who to target. That's actually really nice maneuvering by VG, but now support comes in from the west. Mana burn, those balls come through. Nyx Assassin gets one last attack in to get the kill on the Ruby, but MMY chocked up by Fenrir. But it's actually Super with the level death too that's able to get the kill. So he goes 6-4 now on the board. I don't know if you're going to get your classic Dota Chinese Dota man, but I definitely think you're going to get your 50-minute game. This game is not going to be easy for either team.
No, it's going to be a long game, I think. But I don't know why, but I'm lagging like crazy right now. I can't see anything.
You poor man. Right now I'm fine, so I'm not going to anger the Dota gods.
But just a point I wanted to make about this, even though I'm lagging, was the Morphling CS. It's actually surprisingly good still. Even though he's been harassed a lot, he's been butter refilling and he has decent farm. He has better farm than Tiny actually, at this point.
The only downside for him is the fact that he's going to lose this tier 1 tower in the middle lane. With Ice 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 having the Ring of Aquila, as well as having these 4 levels up in Plague Wards, he really has to just been adding never-ending pressure into that tier 1 tower in mid. So that's going to be their upside. RNTK's upside is the fact he just stole stacks out of the DK jungle. Walks away with committing murder. He's almost got his blink dagger too. That's a nice little steal for FY. Rubik's and Alba still in pal. You're not lagging? Yay!
That's good.
The expert cast being able to see the action normally is an upside, you know.
Actually, Doom is pretty fat too. He has a mech. Wow, he actually got the full mech. That's impressive.
In 9 minutes?
He's 3-0-2 as well, with Max Devour. It's natural.
One thing that we still haven't talked about is going to be the effect of the Wisp now that he's at level 6. Because Relocate is up and running. So Burning can just be brought to this top lane at a moment's notice. Now there's Observers and Sentries, and I think if Fenrir catches Lanham out here now... In fact, Lanham turns.
They want him to go, I think, yeah. So they relocate in. Mm-hmm. But Rubik is also 6, and they have this mech like I mentioned. Rest is almost 6 too.
Yeah, they have the mech, they have the 3-point stun from the Nyx Assassin inside that Rubik.
6 on bad. He's gonna either TP mid or top right now, and they're gonna try and make a fight happen. I think top.
See, if he does though, like, I'm still keeping my eyes on MMY, man. He's going to bring that Tiny in straight away, and Bernie doesn't care right now, because he's fine. He's farming up, in fact he just finished up his drums. So the Aghanim Scepter will be next on the list of things to buy. As Ice 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 is just chasing Siler up the river. But they're keeping him so distracted, like Avalanche Toss, they destroy the creep wave so quickly and then take the towers.
Keep your mind on bottom now, I think they might TP in with this Batrider.
Well, VG Gaming TP in, Blink Dagger, Lasso, you're right, they're going on him. MMY, he's got no mana for Relocate. He can't pull him out. He tethers, in fact, down and away, and Burning will die here. He's even sending the courier back to base. He realized his own death, but in mid lane, Siler's going to go down right now, or is he? He's already going into the strength morph. They need a little bit more DPS in this. He is out of mana, so Ice 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 is trying to keep that poison tick going, but they TP some more support in. ROTK coming in for Ice Ice Ice. Doom the first level death. There's no scorched earth, but Ice 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 will go down. ROTK with a blink into the flame break, and they're able to pick up the kill.
Undying died top as well.
Wow, it's...
But they did get the middle tower, but it's definitely not worth it. They would have gotten that regardless, eventually. This is looking really good for V.
Hearing a relocate coming in towards the top. The stun from FY was just a little bit too early. The Mass Serpent was dropped down too, but Fenrir, with the tombstone dropping down, it's very difficult to run away. He still was able to get the shock as well as the focus fire over on the Wisp, but FY... Nah, Lanham comes in for the double kill. Siler's going to come in to help out, goes on Lanham, and Lanham actually locked in a corner here. Avalanche from Burning, he's going to have to do the toss as well, but Lanham, another decay. Siler, well at least he's able to strength morph this one out, but Doombringer also rotating in. They can't easily get up though the rest of DK to help him out because these Mass Serpent Wards have made a bit more of a buffer there. So they want to try and go on this Morphling, but they just can't do it.
Really good trade-off of VG again, they also got the Wisp in the engagement in the beginning. So that's also totally fine.
The kind of interesting thing too is the fact that VG Gaming now is at about 4.5k on the experience gain. And that was only like, they gained 3k from that last little fight up on the top lane, as well as the other kills in the other lanes. So it was close until that point. At which point now DK are behind the 8 ball.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
At least Bernie's going to get some kind of advantage. Regeneration rune from the bottom. Sala comes down, just going to spot him taking it out. Well, up on top lane, Ice Ice Ice. This is actually a really favorable matchup for Ice Ice Ice. The Venomancer against the Doombringer. Even with Scorched Earth, Ice 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 can control him, and Ice 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 now has the mech up and running too for him, for his team.
I was just about to mention the great ward they had in the jungle, but the FY just found it with these sentries. I'm not sure how he knew. Maybe he saw it when someone went up there earlier, but that was really important for them because that ward was basically showing Batrider and Rubick and all rotation from mid to top.
Oh, it's important, man, to get rid of those wards. Like, they're two perfect sentry wards, because this is the area that Wisp would relocate in for a quick kill. So Batrider is farming up those stacks. It's just a quick jump in and get it. And they're gonna try top lane, I'm pretty sure. Like, Wisp relocate around this area is where they want to go. Because the tether's already up. In fact, they got to wait 3 more seconds before they can go because the tether just went down.
They might go on bottom right now.
Well, there's your jump in. Relocate him out, man. Relocate him out.
Oh, so good.
Pull him out to safety.
I thought you got him with that flim break.
That was a long shackle. And they're TPing Eurus to bottom lane. They're trying to go for the Wisp right now. And actually brings it back with Burning. The Hex will be there. FY stole the toss. Burning, there may be enough burst damage to get through him, but the overcharge turns on. And VG game, because they brought so much support to the bottom lane, means they will lose their tier 1 tower on top.
Yeah, that was a bit weird by VG. Dire's top tower. They put so much effort into that, and now they might lose top.
Yeah, they will. It's Ice Ice Ice, man. A mass wall of plague wards. You gotta try and fight against that. We got a little bit of trouble on bottom lane. Nyx Assassin with the Spy Carapace. Stop Super from moving out there because of the Scorched Earth. FY stole toss again. And with the Shackles, they look for another setup stun. And with the pick up, the toss in, Burning, the Doom will actually pick him off right now. So they're looking for, actually, what? They're soul ripping him? And they're keeping him alive through MMY? Yeah, you gotta deny him.
Oh my god.
He wasn't gonna survive that.
That was so close. Look at top lane as well. What the hell is happening?
if that was 4 points up in the Venomous scale, it would be death right now. But he let off his ultimate and he's got 2 points up in the sting. Veno takes the top tower.
Yeah, Veno with the most seers in the game.
He is looking good, man. Still, the highest net worth does belong to Super. 7.1k over on the Doombringer, which is obviously devour justified. And he's coming into a BKB from the very, very start. Now, I'm actually not 100% sure about this. Like, I know there's still a lot of stunts coming out from DK, but if he gets gunked up by the Venomance before he gets the BKB off, I'm still seeing him getting kited out during these fights.
Yeah, I don't necessarily think he needs it that early. I guess they don't want to lose some fights. If they keep fighting and they lose one fight because Doom didn't go for BKB, then it's problematic.
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna catch the Veno now.
Well, they should. Observer Ward goes down, so they can see him. Blink up, they drag him back down again, and Plague Ward stolen by FY. Now that's a nice thing to have. Ice 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 picked up and dragged back into the fire.
Yep. I feel like they can actually go for mid maybe now with this Plague Wards.
So I'd still be cautious about going for mid. Because you've still got a Wisp relocate with a Tiny. So the problem is, if VG Gaming get caught in this little zone here, and Tiny relocates up into the higher ground, they can basically lose their back-end support here, who they thought was safe, in an instant.
They're going rush.
Yep, this is smarter. This gives them their insurance, they use the Plague Wards correctly. What aura have we got from Super? Okay, so it's just a Centaur aura. But Venomance is coming up, and the Plague Ward, which was stolen by FY, scouts out the moving up Tiny. They do have a little bit of help though. Burning, is he going to be thrown up on the cliff? Yep, Burning stuck for the moment. And they have to relocate him out. There's no other choice right now. And MMY, well,
it's
actually
canceled.
He cancelled the relocate. So he had to back out again. And MMY, well, actually the rest of them are coming in. It's ROTK with the double kill. VG Gaming taking the perfect fight. They did lose the Shadow Shaman for this. Then Lanham will also go down. The Doom on him, and the Morphling committing to the kill. There's still some more stuns, but the Strength Morph's just ticking in. 16, 17, 18, 19, 2k worth of life points now up for Syla. But Ice 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 has come in, the Venomancer ulti has gone to work. The Gale completely balls up there from Ice Ice Ice. Hits on nothing. Roshan almost dead. 800 life points on him. Ice Ice Ice, there's a whole lot of Plague Wards. Who belongs to what? Don't know. But RNTK dragging Ice 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 up onto the hill. Waveform through two with the Flame Break. They're going to try and pick up Mushy. Mushy actually killed off and denied by Roshan. But Roshan himself does go down to VG Gaming. Great fight for VG. They just grabbed so much control during that fight.
Unfortunately, I started lacking during that fight, but it sounded really really interesting. I would have loved to see that Nyx getting killed by Roche.
he was in really way too deep, but at the same time, he got three man stun. And there was the possibility that, well, he didn't really have that much base damage on a Nyx Assassin, so getting a kill would have been a lot more impressive for Mushy. I thought for a moment he was going to deny him the Aegis.
I feel like maybe it was a bit wrong to even take a fight there like that, because I mean, when Tiny gets dropped on the hill and that fails, then you're probably going to lose the fight anyway. But they do want to fight with this undying. I mean, it falls off so hard later on.
When you got a hero like a Venomancer, though, you probably consider that you have enough control that you can just fight everything. Relocate's coming in middle lane after Undying. Just throws out the ulti, throws out the TK, and then gets thrown himself. Fenrir will TP himself out because all the stuns are now gone. Yeah. But they got to get rid of these Plague Wards quickly. But that's fine for Burning. Well, okay, Burning probably wanted to stay there, but he's been taken back up to the top lane. This is going to be the key moment now for DK coming in. So DK, even though they lose that fight, even though things go bad, you're still having Burning being 160 gold away from having his Aghanims.
Yep, that's true. We have BKB up on Doom as well.
Batrider jumping in. This could delay the Aghanims. Relocate again. Maybe they can drag Burning out of this one. Or at least Whisk, get yourself in there. Ted, oh, he's doomed. He's dead. On. And now Tiny is 500 or 450 gold away from his Aghanims.
Yeah.
They can't keep having this delayed. They really, really can't.
I feel like a hero that has been surprisingly good for VG this game has been this Morphling. He, all fights, he just goes in and tanks like Venomous Scale and like all so much focus, so many right clicks, but he never really dies. Mm-hmm. I can never really take him down. And even though he was up against a really hard lane, mid lane, he still managed to get good form. And eventually he will get really fat too. He has 3k gold on top of his Aegis and is level 13. That's really big. He's max level in the game together with Doom and Batrider.
They need to do something about this now, DK, and Mushy's trying to. Vendetta's up. It's only a level 1, so he doesn't really have that much time to scout around, but he had to pop it off the second he went past the tier 1 tower. It's because he knows there's going to be some kind of vision there. And the Observer Ward now does scout him out returning. So there are no Vendettas on cooldown. But that was going to be a setup for Burning. Just a quick kill. That's all they're really searching for. Radiant's bottom tower is and VG Gaming just grouped up as four in the mid. They're ready to fight. But they're actually going to smoke. Now, do they try and walk around? They're out of range of that Observer Ward. So either they're going to use Sylar as bait on this bottom lane, or they smoke and loop into mid.
Yeah, DK is just going to leave that bottom tower because they expect VG to do this move. But it's not really that good for DK because...
Oh, they just revealed themselves. Yep, there goes the ping out from Mushy. So Morphling takes out the bottom tower. That's a nice thing for them. But the Venomancer threw out a Plague Ward and it started attacking on Ice Ice Ice's Plague Ward. He was using it for vision.
As well. There's not much DK can do about it, I think.
Ah, they're getting the wards out, man. With the mass Serpent Wards there, Fenrir is just going to focus him on the tower, just like that. Maybe an attempted denial with the Plague Wards. Yeah, you can see him just stutter attacking with the Plague Wards, thinking about it. But simple rotation from VG.
This is where VG starts snowballing, I think. They've got two towers there, they still have this Aegis. Morph almost at E-Blade.
The Aghanims has arrived, though, for Burning.
Yeah, it has, but they need to dodge fighting right now. They really can't fight this BKB Doom and Blink Dagger on Rasta now as well. It's also going to be hard to dodge because they have this Blink Daggers on both Batrider and Rasta now.
By the way, just a small little thought. I wondered why why it was changed from Warcraft 3 to Dota 2. Why does Tiny start with a tree when he picks up the Aghanim Scepter?
Why not?
Because in Warcraft 3, he picked up a tree.
Oh.
You actually walked up to a tree and you grabbed the tree.
That's true.
That was the Warcraft 3 way of doing it. It's like real world properties. Like Aghanim Scepter now is just actually a tree that the courier is dragging out. Just saying, it's just something to think about. Ice building into his Aghanim Scepter now. It's taking him some time to do this after his start. Because he also purchased up a gem, which sent him back a little bit further. But this is trying to make sure Vici Gaming don't have vision everywhere across the map. But FY right now, he's controlling so much as this Rubick. Just having the Plague Wards. The Plague Wards letting him go absolutely everywhere and check everything.
He is basically a Venomancer right now.
Yeah.
With the Disable. And the Nuke. They're gonna take two towers top. I don't know if DK is gonna make it. Because Batrider is just still gonna sit in fog. They actually do have vision on that tower.
They're gonna try and fight, man. They've actually gotta try and fight. But they gotta wait 15 seconds. Avalanche is on cooldown for burning. So they can't fight just yet.
I don't think it's a... Oh, actually, Aegis is out. This is probably why they want to do it.
Yep.
But it's still a really hard fight to take.
Up against E-Blade, up against a Batrider Initiation. Lamb's already on the front lines with the ulti up. And that just basically means they mean business. This tower's not dead yet. The glyph's going to be used. If they want to try and save this tower, the backdoor regeneration is keeping it alive for now, but they don't use glyph, which means they don't fight. They just try and take a trade. Burning will take the tier 2 tower out in the bottom lane. There's TB support coming in from the Batrider. He does have Blink Dagger, and he goes straight on Burning. That'll be a cover Avalanche, but they'll go into the Shackle. Hey! Relocate for the first time. It is able to work to save Burning's life. And they'll wait for Wisp. Wisp is actually going to kind of get lucky. The creep wave's going to be in range for him to tether out. So they need a straightaway stun, and they got it. The Hex is there, the follow-up Centaur Stomp, and they pick off the Wisp.
But that was a good trade for DK nonetheless. They saved themselves some more time, and Burning got Wisp at the tower, but still. Just what they could have, like, what they could do in that situation.
Yeah.
Taking that fight was still too hard.
It's a 1-1 trade with a hero. That's a 1-1 tower trade with a hero, with a support hero going down. Yeah. Considering DK's position when they're 8.5k gold behind and 12k experience behind, that kind of trade's a good trade. And they don't really care as long as Burning gets bigger. As long as Burning doesn't die, and he gets to keep farming up. Like, this guy's already got Aghanims as well as Yasha. So Burning just needs time.
And bottom lane. Yeah, he will get big as well, for sure. I'm not sure if it's going to be enough, though. They have some really good disable for this Tiny.
He basically needs to get a BKB on this Tiny next.
And the thing is that DK, they're kind of having this... I wouldn't say a full protect one, but he is the only carry in their lineup. He is the only guy to physical damage, so... When this guy, when Super just dooms him in the fights, it's gonna be really hard to fight for them. So I'm still a bit worried for DK. I don't think I think it's gonna be hard for them to pull through this game. But I mean, it's not over at all yet.
They basically just need a favorable trade. That's what DK need. They need VG Gaming to basically not see a backdoor coming or something along those lines. That's why this bottom lane is probably gonna be the key for DK. Keep that lane pressured out. Obviously, he's still got two tier 2 towers up on the map for VG Gaming, but they're on mid as well as top. But if they can pick up that bottom racks...
I mean, a fight where DK can win can happen still, though. But if they get a Venomancer, Aghanims, and they get the right engagement from a Nukes or something, or if they fight with Vibex, it's definitely possible.
About to go on Syla. There's a relocate. Yep, she's coming in right now, and they got to do it. There's your relocate, but Syla waveforms away. He's still got his replica to jump to while Lanham being really controlled up in the Alderman form, trying to soul rip himself up, but he'll go down. They lost Mushi as well, and the whole they could take fights remains as a theory. Not practice. VG Gaming now 22-10, and with those two heroes down, they could look to take out the remaining tier 2 towns of DK.
Yeah, I'm lagging, man.
All I'm saying is, man, I feel your level of depression. That's All I'm saying,
the engagement happened, just when Nuke stunned.
I understand your pain. even through that fight, man, it was this weird kind of situation. Undying was actually really, really tanky then. He almost survived all of those control abilities. We kind of actually underestimate Lanham. Now he's managed to finish up a pipe as well. Like, we kind of... Yeah, his... Even for a hero who's got 6.5k net worth, he was tankier than Tiny.
Another point I want to make is that both Rest and Rubick, Batrider, they all have Blink Daggers, and Doom is super tanky, and then there's more of a waveform. So it's really easy for VG, and on the other hand, really hard for DK to actually... Like, to not get outplayed in these fights, you know?
Yeah.
It's easy for the supports to sit back and wait for the right opportunity to go in. Doom will always be in front. He has BKB, he doesn't care. Same with the Morphling, he can strength up, wave out if necessary, and Batrider. It's easy for VG to just initiate with the Batrider or the heroes and then get out too, you know? So it's... Yeah.
Yeah. VG Gaming's initiation is wonderful. And with the BKB, Batrider dragback, hell yeah, man. I think there's no one from DK that can control him then. The only thing that could interrupt the Batrider is a relocate out. That's the only thing that will interrupt this lasso. And that's not really been very reliable, as we've seen throughout tonight. And are they considering going? Yeah, they want to come back in for Roshan again. DK is already here. Ice remains in close inside the smoke, putting a ward inside the pit as well. In the meantime, though, we got a lot of farm coming in for this Tiny. Like, he's finished Amanda style.
Yeah.
So this is Burning realizing that he can't push out the lanes himself by being there. So just pop the mana style. Just let it push out the lanes by themselves. You still get the farm. You don't get the experience, but you get the farm.
Yeah, Tiny just got 16, and he is getting farm. But on the other hand, Morphling just picked up a full BKB. Same with Batrider. And they're going mid.
They were thinking about it.
Oh, and relocate used. But
yeah.
Not the time. Spells were casted.
Yeah. Spells were casted and nothing happened.
Yeah.
The ultimate anticlimax. It's gonna be a fire! It's just gonna be... It's gonna be stationary is what it is. Ice coming back over to the pit. They do not want to let Roshan happen without a contest. And FY again. It's such a wonderful hero,
oh,
Rubick.
That's so annoying. That's so annoying, man.
He's basically going to set up a perimeter. Yeah, you see it. Ward here, and then just basically make a line across this direction.
It's kind of funny, right? Because they first picked this Venomancer just to get the ward stolen by the Rubick.
Mm-hmm. It's the beautiful thing about a Rubick, man. One of my favorite heroes in the game. And FY is just... Like, I'm not even going to say it's going to be hard. It really isn't looking to be hard at all to do what he's doing. Alright, so...
This Doom, man. Look at this Doom. 8-0 and 8.
See, my eyes aren't actually staying on the Doombringer. And I know I'm seeing a couple of people sitting there right now in the chat going, oh my god, DK fanboy. It's probably like, well, I'm watching DK so closely. Funny thing is, I'm actually more of a VG Gaming fanboy. Burning is farming at an insane rate. He's actually managed to outfarm the Doombringer at this point. He's 500 net worth in front, now building into an AC, picks up the Hyperstone. He's getting a lot bigger. Once this AC is up and running, and then the Daedalus arrives as well, I know we're talking a long time from now, but with the space they keep giving Burning, he's catching up quickly. He's actually 60 CS in front of the Morphling.
That's true enough. What VG are focusing on doing right now is they're trying to find that fight. You know, they're going as five. They're going Morphlings farming, and they're only showing up with a few people until they get to the tower. So Doom is not like effectively farming. He's mainly just using his Devourer when off cooldown. Where Tiny is just raw farming. You know, he. That's all he does. But yeah, it might become a problem. He has AC soon as well.
Yeah.
You know what a Tiny with 6 slots can do. It's not a joke.
This is the reason why I'm sitting here going, this game is not over. It's like, well, 11k gold advantage and 15k worth of experience advantage going the way of VG Gaming. But I'm also looking at the Morphling, and I'm not seeing an unstoppable force yet. I'm seeing a guy that's very difficult to kill, but he doesn't have the butterfly up and running. He went for the E-Blade. He can still get picked off. Obviously, Aegis the Immortal is the wonderful insurance kind of policy he's got, but VG Gaming getting high ground and winning this up against a wall of Plague Wards, what is now a full Aghanim's ulti for Ice 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 is coming out on the courier. There's a lot of problems facing VG Gaming. Yeah, the fight, yeah, I'm with you on that one, man. VG Gaming, they want to fight.
I mean, DK might... Are they just going to give this power up as well?
Yeah, there's no reason to defend it. Because if they go out there, they run the risk of getting Blink Lassoed, and that's what shut down the Tiny time and time again throughout this game. Yeah, they got to come back the rest of DK. They've got two players AWOL on bottom lane, but that's the Wisp as well as the Tiny. So they have to relocate and fight this. There's the Batrider jumping in. So Firefly's already been used. Spike Carapace is going to stun him up for a moment. But the Decay keeps going out as well. So you're going to have an Undying. He's got 2 points stolen on the Decay. Nick's done. There goes your tier 3 tower. Where's the relocate? There it comes in. Scylla already beating down. He's trying to bring down Mushy, but this ghost is actually Vendetta is saving him. Burning, locked outside the pit. Fenrir is controlling him up. Not to mention he's doomed. Then they commit the last two. Waveform out and the relocate. It drags him to the bottom lane. Now Burning is actually living because the stick charges keep him alive. So they're just going to force out the bottom lane. They save the middle lane. And Burning leaves his Mana Star Illusions to push at the bottom. VG Gaming actually have to bail out.
But I just want to make another point that when they went uphill there, they had basically 15,000 gold unspent on VG Zeros. Doom sitting on 5k, Rasta 4k, Morphling 4k, Batrider almost 3k, and Rubick also have 2k. So they didn't have to do that. And they could still just fight them straight up. So they're... I feel like they're really far ahead, but it was kind of amazing that no one died there. Wow.
Big swing, but no ding. But, okay, so you're talking about unspent gold coming out from VG Gaming. I'm also still looking at Burning, who now has his Assault Cuirass. If he wants to buy it, not have buyback available.
Oh god, Doom just picked up a full Refresher Orb, just casually.
Really?
He's buying the Perseverance right now.
Wow.
That's the border BKB, Batrider bots, Morphling still 5k.
So what, we're going double Doom? So he's searching for the initial hit over on the Venomancer and then the follow-up one into the Tiny?
Or one on Tiny and then Tiny bites back and then another one on Tiny. Who knows? It can be like that.
That's right, didn't just go straight into the Aghanim's upgrade.
I guess he could have gone for an assault instead. I'm not sure they need this refresher right now.
Yeah, it kind of seems like overkill.
Yeah, it's not that bad, but it's not needed, I think.
They're going to smoke up and try and look for a kill. So four of them together. There is one straggler, which is Scylla. He's...
Portamenta just now. So now they have spent their gold, and now they're really strong. They bought a 4-star on Rubick as well. They have BKB on Rasta.
I'm still seeing pressure. A Tiny with 300 cleave damage with the AC up.
And how about this Aegis? Is that... When is that running out?
It just gave the marker. It just gave us our marker, and I didn't look at it. We got trouble with Burning DCing out.
Yeah, Chinese stuff.
But the Aegis Immortal, it's only got 30 seconds. It's only got 30 seconds left on the Aegis.
30 seconds?
Yep.
Okay.
There's no fortification either for DK right now, so they can't just stall it up waiting for that 30 seconds to run out.
I don't think they're going to be able to kill him before this 30 seconds.
No. This is...
But actually, Burning bought his full AC, so this fight could be game if they lose.
Mm-hmm. This is what I'm looking at, man. This is the power that I will not underestimate. But at the same time, until he gets his BKB up and running, he's still gonna get controlled. It's the funny thing is, it's not even the last two. We saw how much time it took for VG Gaming to try and kill Burning in the last fight. They had to keep him shackled and basically telekinesis for a little bit longer. in order to control him long enough to get the kill. The last two timing wasn't long enough.
Thing is, they can afford to use literally all their disables on this Tiny because there is no other damage coming out of anyone else.
So you're not even considering the damage that Venno's capable of pumping out, or Lanham as well?
He pops his ultimate and his scale, and then what? You don't really care about disabling the Venno, right?
True.
If you can pick him off, then it's amazing, but they don't need to, I think.
Vici Gaming's giving him the space, man. They're backing up. I got a funny feeling that Vici Gaming were also looking at that countdown timer on the Aegis the Immortal. 5 seconds, there she is. So, yep. Aegis will disappear.
They're just gonna wait for next Aegis, I think. Maybe try and get pick-offs. This will give DK an opportunity to get 5 buybacks, or another item on Burning.
Look how defensive Burning's being. This is the big problem right now for DK. They have no idea where VG Gaming are. They have one ward on the map. One ward.
And at the same time, they're playing against Batrider, so it's yep. really, really scary.
It's like, how do you even put a ward down? Batrider's walking around with a gem too, so the second you put down some defensive observer wards, Batrider fireflies and sees them and picks them up.
You don't. You're going to have to wait for VG to show up. Now they know they're probably going to be around mid because Morph just showed up.
Yep. And then the rotation up top. This is still the one ward they have. This little sucker right here.
Yeah.
So that they'll see if Vici Gaming ward back. It's the vision it cuts across here. So they'll see if someone walks up to the shop or up into... Wait, we got a lasso? Oh, wow. I heard the lasso effect. I'm like, wait, no one's outside the base. It was the tiny illusion that they ended up going on.
Yeah.
But that bait was prepped as well by Burning. I don't know if you're watching in the bottom lane, but he didn't actually show his actual hero. He walked out the illusion to the creep wave, then dragged it back, and then moved it up
yeah,
this direction.
That was probably intentional.
Yeah. He basically did the pre-bait against VG Gaming with the illusion.
What was I saying? Yeah, but what I was saying is this Morphling, you know, even though he does show up on the map, DK can't be sure of where the rest are, because it's Morphling, you know? It's super hard to kill this Morphling with BKB and Replicate Up. It's almost impossible, especially for the lineup of DK. They don't have Disable and Burst to kill him.
Okay, I want to ask you this question, man. Mm-hmm. Should Burning buy a BKB, or should he go for the win? Should he go for the Crystallis straight away? Because soon you'll have enough money to buy the Crystallis.
I am not sure. I feel like... I feel like first of all he needs to fight with buyback maybe and try and just do as much damage as he can, make them waste their spells and then try and buyback.
With Refresh your Tomb, is it enough though?
I think it's hard, but I feel like he both needs BKB and he needs a Daedalus.
Yeah.
So he might want to go for the... There's also another option of going Butterfly.
That's true, because no one's going to go a Monkey King Bar over on VG Gaming.
But he really needs that BKB. He really does.
Yeah. But at the same time, he needs to be able to wipe out VG Gaming quickly.
And even when he pops BKB, VG are not just going to sit there behind each other and get cleaved. They're just going to move away and dodge him.
What's he coming up for?
What?
I don't know. I thought for a moment he's walking to the shop. I'm like, wait, the only reason why you go there is if he's considering a heart or something along those lines. But they want the creep wave on the top.
I mean, he could go for some more damage just to farm faster, but then again he really farms fast now, so that's not even necessary for him.
Yeah, look at him pushing out the top lane. Morphling's up here, so Sala's gonna see Burning up here as well. Burning doesn't really seem to care that much, but he might have to care in a moment. ROTK is scouting out the rest of his teammates, so Mushy, he's the one on the front lines. In fact, he's going to go in, Spike Carapace. They find this one. Relocate's going to come in. And now we'll see how much damage they can dish out. Fenrir, he got the shackle, but he's still going to go down here. Burning, moving over to ROTK. Now, the Doom is over right now, but it's not on Burning. So he's able to keep on fighting, bashing into Super. The Relocate, in fact, pulling out somebody else from this fight. But the Venomancer is still here. The Refresher has been used. So Doom is back up again, but Super, he is very, very slow right now. Triggers off his BKB, he gets the Doom on Burning, but that won't kill off Burning. Even if FY has made still Venomancer Gale, MMY comes in with the tether. He'll slow him down right now, and FY, he will go down to the Wisp. Lanham came in for the rotation, and Super is still not out of trouble. Burning's take this up. The mid rank is not looking too healthy. Ice come back to defend this, but Burning's chasing down Super. Avalanche towards the high ground. Toss as well. Super level death, but he's on the sidelines for 75 seconds and buys back instantly. He doesn't want an Aegis of the Immortal over on this Tiny. And they use the Mana Star Illusion to scout it out. He's already used the Shiva's Guard.
Good fight there for DK. It was a good initiation by Mushi. Even though he got lifted right away, he did get the Spike Carapace off on the Batrider. And they killed Rast off instantly before he even dropped wards, I think. So that was really good. Burning is now on 4.5k gold. And yeah, Refresher was used, BKB, everything has is on cooldown.
They threw everything, but the first Doom went out.
Was that on an illusion or what happened with that?
I didn't see what hero
maybe
went on.
Maybe on the dead Nyx or something? I don't know.
I went looking for it and there was nothing left. RTK instantly stunned the Spike Carapace and then they follow up on the Summon Super. They're going to lose the Doombringer. This is disastrous for Vici Gaming. The BKB's popped by the Shadow Shaman.
No buyback.
Yep, no buybacks available. It's a huge death timer as well because he bought back instantly to defend Roshan and now Burning is beating on a tier 3 tower.
TK should go take that Roshan right now, I feel.
Yep, agreed. Get that Aegis the Immortal in the back of Tiny, maybe even just sell
the
drums.
Venomancer sit out there and get a Venomancer ult off if they want to fight. I think Morphling still has buyback.
And RTK can't even blink down for this. It's Fireflies coming off cooldown. I don't know if they can do this fast enough. They've got to try and take a fight because Batrider can cause them a large amount of issues.
They should definitely just abuse the fact that Doom can't.
Yeah, they're coming for it. BKB from Syla, mushing into the Spike Carapace, but the E-Blade destroys him almost instantly. Burning, shackled up for now, but he's still got Fenrir right in front. One swing, two swing, just kills off the Raster. So there's now 2 Euros down for VG Gaming. The Nyx Assassin is, of course, down for DK.
Ah, this should be Roche. They can kill it before VG can get there, I think.
Yeah, VG Gaming have to go back and heal. That's what they've really got to do.
And Mushi, Burning bought up his BKB now. And still have 3k gold in the bank. But what the fuck? What is happening?
Does he sell the drums?
how is DK coming back from this?
Dude, let's see. Calling her from the start, man. You do not underestimate the farm on a Tiny. If he gets positioned, you can do anything you want. Now, Syla, they're going to try and jump in for the jump. Killed by the Radiant, picked up by Tiny. He's got the Aegis, RTK, 118 life points. Burning is the E-Blade, so at least Burning stops attacking him for now. Syla with the space, FY, ends up stealing at least a toss. Ice, low on life, and there's Morphling. Kills him off, waves away, and tosses the Tiny back. The Wiz comes back the other way. We're watching a game of tennis. Except Burning is Roger Federer. 26-18. Tiny is so damn beefy, and he fought that without his BKB. He's gonna point that one out. The courier came out to deliver it, but he was full up, so it just took it straight back again.
Just before that fight happened at Roche, I was just about to say, what DK actually needs to come back into this game is like a perfect fight, and now they got like 2 perfect fights, even 3 in a row. And got an Aegis on Tiny, and now he has a casual BKB sitting on chicken, and he has still 4k gold.
Even now, Lanham. We kind of even forget about Lanham during these fights. Have you noticed that, like, in every single fight, like, the Tombstone's being down, right. Now he picks up a Veil of Discord as well. He's kind of been like the unsung hero of DK. Point,
if he's next to a target, they take 30% more damage. And they have a Veil now on MF as well, and Blads, and he's like, they actually kind of need to kill that guy. Yep.
He's basically giving Burning what he needs to fight. It's like Melee Hero. Here, have Vladimir's offering as well on the back of this. Lanham, if he wants to, when this Aegis goes down, he can pick up a full Daedalus.
Now VG kind of needs to slow the game down all of a sudden. Because I don't think they can fight this Tiny right now with this Aegis.
They at least have the full butterfly finished on Syla. That's their upside.
But no buyback either.
Well, the buybacks are available
only really
for
die, though.
Tiny and Wisp are the only ones that can buy back right now.
Yep. Oh, this is gonna be. This is game breaking. This fight. This is really important.
DK is gonna force it. The Mass Serpent War still not even level 3 yet. We're 45 minutes in. We don't have a level 16 roster. Their level of hold is just not really there. But DK is going to knock on the front door. So in they come. Burning in. starts speeding on the tower, and Super, there's your Doom. They're going to drag Burning back. Maybe a little bit of overcommitment, but remember, he's got the Aegis of the Immortal, so even if he goes down right now, it's not as bad. But Doom's got one. Refresher Orb to go again. Now,
Wisp is dead, though.
Doom is available. Yep, you're right. Wisp is dead, so the extra control is gone and Burning. Does he get out of this one safely? There's the BKB. Fenrir is right in itself. He won't get out of this one. He's going to die right now. He's trying to attack on Fenrir, realizing death is near, trying to kill somebody, but he goes out and double buybacks will come. They're going to come back. It might have been intentional. They're ready to fight. Both of the Dooms are down. Fenrir gets picked off over the side, and they're going to breach him through the mid. The relocate is what dragged him in. Has to separate the tether so Burning can stay on the front, front lines. But even then, that damage on Burning, this could be real troublesome. Super's in there, FY, they're able to get the kill. The stolen stun returns it in. And now Burning, Lasso controlled. He'll die right now. Have DK just overcommitted and possibly thrown the game? They are dragged back.
100 seconds on Tiny now.
Vici Gaming almost have to run straight down the mid and take this.
Crazy Chinese Dota. This all this reminds me of some no offense, but some kind of Russian.
No. That was calculated. That was still calculated at the end of the day. I just don't think DK thought that the Tiny could die three times over.
Yeah, I agree. I also thought it was a good move, but it's also super risky. Right?
Yeah, oh, definitely. When you're playing with nothing but buybacks, it's of course risky as hell.
Yeah. Wisp even had a cheese on him, actually. He could have healed the Tiny.
But he got nuked down at the very, very start of that fight. That was really the saving grace right then for VG Gaming. The fact that Wisp wasn't there to make sure Doom had the extra regen, extra heals. And Mushy is just going to try and keep him out. Batrider, ooh, jumps in, he found Mushy. They're going to pull him out. And now this could, in fact, be just a move for GG.
Rolling, isn't it?
Yeah, the relocate Wisp is also about to come back in again. Look at Super, into the BKB. Doom is available. He may as well even just throw it out nice ice ice. In fact, they just nuke him. Sylar pops ice ice ice. Then they go to Lanham. The Doom is on him. He'll go back to base right now. But they're about to lose their mid ranks, and they should lose more than this. They should lose a lot more than this, DK.
It's down to 10 seconds on Tiny now, but they're gonna lose two Rexes.
Oh, dude.
It's not over yet, man. VG might go for the fountain dive.
Ah, they're backing up.
They're backing off. Alright.
Okay. Now call the point. Tiny, get rid of the TP scroll. Pick up the Crystallis. You must fight like full man.
Let's see. Maybe Butterfly is better, honestly. I'm not sure, but they don't have... I guess they have a Hex on Rasta, but apart from that, they don't really have... they don't really have Sight Device.
I don't mind the Butterfly, but I look at the Daedalus, saying that if they're even going to attempt a backdooring, they're going to need the Daedalus damage.
On buildings, it's kind of the same, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's not. I guess Daedalus is more, but...
Daedalus just has a slight increase in the damage compared. I don't know about if you take into account like the DPS, like the attack speed that also comes out from the Butterfly. just remind yourself there, Syla. Remind the world. 43-20 on the mark.
The other day too, the Chinese teams just wrote it in all chat.
What was it? We're talking about these teams being really quite close-knit, personal kind of thing. And
I don't know, because it's Chinese, it's hard to say if it's just a coincidence or if it's actually like kind of a taunt.
It's a friendly kind of thing.
Because DKMY did it right after they won the fight, and now Vici just won a big fight, and now Sylar did it. So it might be just an annoying taunt.
You call it like mind games, like, yo guys, 2 minutes, Roshan's up, are you ready to fight? You remember what happened last
something
time?
Something like that. Like, what are you going to do when Rosh spawns? You have two Rexes down now, and we're pushing
Tiny.
Top.
So, this is how Burning responds to the Doom. He's now going to go in with the Lincolns.
I'm not a big fan of that. They have so much... They have leveled death, they have Rubik Nuke, they have Lightning, Shackle. They have so many spells.
They can go through it, yeah.
And I have a feeling he's not going to kill everyone doing his BKB time.
Oh, DK. Are they really going to try this? They're going to attempt to sandwich VG Gaming. The TPs are coming in from ROTK, and the smoke will break. Mushy up in the stun. They start an ROTK. Wisp relocate comes in as well. Massive Wards in behind the lines right now for VG Gaming, but it's not. This is a mess. This is an absolute mess. The Venomancer ulti has gone off for the moment, but they're tossing the Morphling down. Fenrir, he's on one life points. He can't go critical from that hold, but burning. No, Lincoln's Fear didn't really work for him, did it? Doomed up, ROTK low on life. He's trying to find the last point of damage, but it was just the waveform from Sylar and the right click from Doom. They bring him down. Mushy's being controlled solo by FY. Stealing, what's he got? He's just got the stun again, but they call the GG.
What a game.
It was
that became much more dramatic than I expected after what was it, 30 minutes or whatever?
Yep. See, but the funny thing is though, like I was sitting there expecting 45 minutes to have it happen exactly what happened. The tiny, so big that you just take fight after fight up against VG Gaming, and then you're able to breach into the high ground.
It doesn't take much mistakes. It doesn't take much out of position or whatever. One bad fight, then this tiny kills everyone.
What's crazy is just that dive. Just that dive straight down the middle.
Yeah, three lives on Tiny.
Yeah.
It was gone in like 1 minute.
It was... I didn't actually realize that a carry that farm could die that many times in that short space of time. It was ridiculous. Either way...
When he went up with Aegis, it looked like, ooh, this is going to be a hard fight for VG, but...
It looked like a bait. And it was a bait. At the end of the day, all he was looking to achieve was to jump in there, have a bait, and then have them try and attack him. That's all he was looking to achieve. And he achieved it. Unfortunately, he just really, they underestimated the control of VG Gaming. They really underestimated it. I don't know if they weren't ready for the refresher orb on Doom. Even then, that wasn't really the big playmaker. It was Shadow Shaman. It was the Batrider. It was the Rubik. Those were the three guys that were able to control the Tiny in the last moments there.
Yeah, it's true. They kind of underestimated each other at different times. First, it was VG who were like, oh, we got this. We can just casually do whatever we want. And then suddenly they lose a fight, and then they buy back, and then they lose again. And then they almost lose a Rex and lose the game. But then DK underestimates VG, and then it's the same story, just the different, like, the other way around.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Well, let's have a break, man. Let's have a break. We're going to be back here in a couple of moments' time. Game number three, DK going up against VG Gaming, the winner of which will be into the grand final, the loser of which will actually go down to face Dreamtime in the lower bracket final tomorrow. So make sure you stay tuned. Game number three coming up in just a moment.